Hey gang, Christian here with you today for the CETIS design team, and I want to welcome you to this episode of QuickTips. And in this episode today, we're going to be talking about using whiteboards in WebEx. Now, as you can see from my desktop, I am in my meeting center now, and in the upper left-hand corner, you're going to see this little icon labeled New Whiteboard. And if I click on this icon, I'm now going to be sharing a whiteboard, just like a traditional whiteboard that you would find in your classroom, with the rest of the participants in my meeting room. So what's kind of cool about this is anyone can use the whiteboard. So if you want to add some collaboration to your meeting, you can have any one of the participants also add their own thoughts, text, shapes to this whiteboard. So let's go down the tool list over here on the left-hand side. The first one is an arrow, and that's really just you can kind of call out your name or if you want to direct someone's attention to a certain object that's on this whiteboard, you can put the arrow wherever you would like it to go. If you don't want to use the arrow and you just want to use your little laser pointer, you can click on this one and just kind of point around to different elements of the whiteboard if you have some text or perhaps some points that you want folks to pay attention to. The next one down is the text option. So it gives you a little cursor, and wherever you click, that's going to open up an area for you to type. So for example, hello there. And then we're going to go with point one, two, and three, and idea 4, 5, and 6. Try that again, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, now with the text, you can always change the color. So if you'd rather have it, let's say black, we can do 7, 8, 9. Or if you'd rather have it as, let's say red or something to that effect, we can do 10, 11, 12. Okay, below the text is a line. So you can do a single arrow, a double arrow, or just a standard underline. So with the line itself, we can just underline that object there or text or whatever it is. Or if we want to say, hey, these two ideas here, they have some relation to each other, we can do that. And then below that, we've got these shapes. So we have the square shape, and that's exactly what it says is. We'll just draw a box around something. There's an oval, and then there's these two little marks. There's a check mark and an X mark. So let's say, hey, you know what? Some students are adding their own thoughts or ideas to this whiteboard, and you want to say, that's a great idea. We can make it a green check mark and say, oh, wait, that was a great idea. Or, you know, that idea right there, let's stay away from that. So we'll say X. We don't like 7, 8, 9 very much. And then the tool below that is the pencil tool and the pen tool. My personal preference is the pencil tool because it's a thinner line. And that's really just a freehand kind of drawing tool. Below that is, again, is the color. You can change the different color of whatever it is that you're adding to the screen. And then below that is the eraser tool. So we can remove any one of the objects that, let's say, we don't particularly want or we don't need anymore. And then finally, down at the very bottom is a save, and you can save this whiteboard in your computer for future reference. So if you want to review it later or save it for, let's say, your students, you can send it out to your students or upload it to Blackboard so everybody can kind of see what was done in the whiteboard. It's a very helpful tool for that. And then the last thing I'll say is with these whiteboards, you can have as many open as you would like simply by clicking on the New Whiteboard button. So I hope you found this particular tutorial helpful. And as always, we will see you in the next video. Thank you.